family that stays together. And so if it's anything that's going to deliver us in this hour and in this time, sufficient grace, you got to realize that it's going to be the power, the influence, and the grace of prayer. I feel the Holy Ghost. There are seven principal covenants that God generally has released to the church. I'm going to list these seven covenants to you, and I want you to begin to learn. I want you to pen this down and to have this for information as a backdrop that would have you to go back to it and begin to research and look into it. The first covenant being the Abrahamic covenant. The second covenant being the Noahic covenant. The third covenant being the Davidic covenant. The fourth covenant being the Messianic covenant, the fifth covenant being the Mosaic covenant, the eternal covenant, which is a reflection now of the new covenant. And you got to understand what covenant actually deals with now is an agreement that is unequivocal, that is not broken, that is not breached, that is not severed, that is not to be damaged or rearranged by anything or anyone. Because one of the things you must understand, my family, is that God now doesn't necessarily break covenant. God doesn't necessarily tell lies. And if he establishes something down on the inside of you, then you got to understand that that thing is established. And can I suggest to you now that many people in this hour don't understand the value of covenant, the power of covenant, the integrity of covenant, the security of covenant. Whenever God releases now a word over your life and in your life, you must understand that his word is secure. It is guaranteed. It is fireproof. It is guaranteed. It is indisputable and irrefutable.